Hi everyone, I'm here to discuss about the Dyson Supersonic hairdryer that I've encountered problems with while my partner has. This is my first YouTube video, so wish me luck. Now, what the issue was, I've seen some people with videos online showing what's happening, but not really any help to anybody because we all know that's happening, we didn't know why it's happening. Okay, so what issues we were recurring was when this was plugged in and turned on, you see the back here, you've got your heat, your fan speed. Now, we turned it on, nothing was happening, it was blank, it was dead. But then, just for a brief second, these lights flicked. Just a pulsation, just flicked for a second. Now, that leads me to believe that there's a problem with the circuit inside, or there could be a problem along the cable wiring, there could be anything. A problem inside the molded plug. Now, it's a power supply issue. When I first seen this problem, I thought, right, I'll check the fuse. Now, your fuse is 30 amp fuses and everything. It's in kettles, it's in lights, it's everything. It's a standard size. So I'll just show you quickly how to check the fuse, just in case that might be the issue. It isn't the issue with me, but it could be with you, or you might have an issue with your kettle in a couple months' time or something. This is just a quick check, see if you call an electrician. Now, this molded plug, it's molded for a reason. I stopped people playing with it, basically. The old plugs used to get screws and you could take them apart yourself and the wires would be there. So it's just a safety issue, nothing wrong with that. Molded plug, there's no issues with that. Right, okay, all you need is a wee flat-headed screwdriver, something like this. And all you do is, you put it in the slots, it's very simple. Put it in the slots in the plug, I'll show you closer once I take the screwdriver out. And you just lever against it, and out it pops the plastic protector. Now, in there, you'll see, well, the number 13A, 13 amp. That's your fuse. Same again, to take it out, wee screwdriver in the back here. It's hard to get a good angle. A wee screwdriver in the back here, you'll see it yourself once you do it. And you just do the same as what you did with the cover. Leave it against the plug, and out it pops. There's a wee fuse there. I'll just let you see it, so you know what I'm talking about. Now, that's your 13 amp fuse there. Now, that'll be in everything. You know, basically every plug has got one of these, and they're all the same size. So they're easy to get if you do ever have any issues. They're very inexpensive also, they're cheap. So don't just throw anything out, make sure that's okay first if there's any power issues. Now, back to this issue that we've occurred. Now what to do is go online. Now go online and register. You might have done it already. If you've done it already, you're better than me because we didn't. So register online. Now what your cable will have, this is your power cord. I'll have something like this. This is the most important number for any manufacturer, for anything, TVs, iPods, Samsung phone, whatever. This number here is the most important. That's a serial number. That is a unique number to that hairdryer, so they can pinpoint who built it, where the parts came from, when it was bought, when I bought it, when the supplier bought it. This is the golden number here. Now, your cable should have it. If not, your box will have it stickered on as well. Most of us don't keep our boxes like me. They throw them in the bin, and then 2 months later, something like this happens. But on mine's lucky enough, it's on the power cord. So go on to Dyson online and register it. It doesn't matter how old it is, get it registered, get in the system, because it'll save you time. Now, what you need to do is you need to phone Dyson up. Explain to them over the phone the issues, exactly what you have. And they'll ask you basic issues, check the fuse. If yours is doing the same with mine's, there's a slight flicker of the light, there's nothing wrong with the fuse because there is a power supply going there. So that answer, is the fuse okay? Is a yes. Is the power supply okay? Well, if your lights are on in your house, your power supply is okay. So that's a yes as well. And then what they will ask you, now this is the way to answer it. Now they're going to ask you about the filter at the bottom here. I'm going to show you it, okay? Because this is a potential get out clause for all these manufacturers. If you answer this wrong, they can put down to poor maintenance, etc. and try and wiggle their way out of it. But with a high-end company like Dyson, you buy quality, you pay £300, expect quality service. So I shouldn't think that'd be an issue, but anyway, I'm just going to tell you guys anyway, because I don't want people stumbling up on a simple question like that and losing out in £300 hairdryer. Okay, so what they'll ask you is the filter is here. You guys probably know it's there anyway, and all you need to do is you just click it anti-clockwise and out it comes. Now this one's very clean, you see it's really clean. We actually clean it, and all you got to do is you just got to give it a wipe and a clean. Some hair dust and soot from the air will get into that, that's no dramas. But if they ask you, Dyson, all you need to say is, yes, I check it and clean it regularly, every week. And that answer covers that. Because what they'll try and say is, if that's clogged up, it's overheated, the motor or electronics inside, that then has caused the product to fail. And then that is your problem because you never did it. That's a potential way of getting out of it. So guys, all you've got to do is phone them up. If you want to save time, you can register it online yourself, or phone them up, they'll register it on the phone with you. But for me, the best way is to do it online. It saves time in the phone, and you want to get off the phone and go and do your own things. So get your serial number, the only number you need. Put in all your personal details, etc. Now, what Dyson did with me, this one's under a year old, but there should be a 2-year warranty with it, with the electrical consumables. And I just told them the story. I said, yeah, I checked the filter, yeah, it's clear, it's fine, do it regularly. There's a power supply, yes. The fuse is okay, yes. There's only 3 questions, and that's 3 questions. So basically, it's a yes. And they'll then turn around and say that it needs repair because they know it's something internally, circuit board, or it's an actual faulty cable, a break. They'll know all about it already. They've probably had thousands or hundreds of phone calls about these. So don't worry about it. It costs a lot of money. So get on the phone, you know, get on the phone and you've paid a lot of money, hard-earned money. Get it sorted out, because the end product of me is we're getting a new hairdryer, brand new hairdryer. I'm away, so they're delivering it to my fiance's workplace, and can't ask for any better than that. But it's an exchange service, so just to let you know, keep your old hairdryer, because you will have to. It's an exchange, part exchange, so you will have to, you know, give them the old one for you to get the new one. But that's no worries. But they will deliver it to any address you want. And I've just got off the phone with them. It's 3:30, 4:00 now, and they're delivering it within 2 days. So that's pretty good going. So don't worry about it. Give it a phone. You bought quality, expect quality. Give them a ring. Get yourself a new hairdryer. Don't take any chances with electrical. It's dangerous stuff when you're playing with electric. So don't be shy. If you don't ask, you don't get. Simple as that. Anyway, thanks very much. Hope you enjoyed my first video. And if there's any questions, just comment below. But I think I've covered it pretty well. It's a case of get registered, get on the phone, and get it sorted out as soon as possible, and get yourself a new hairdryer. You paid £300 or whatever you're from the world, get your money's worth. That's why you went to Dyson. You didn't buy a £30 hairdryer because you wanted quality. Okay, guys, take care.